Good everybody and welcome back to my channel. So everyone's out at the moment, I'm home for the holidays and I thought, well, might as well make a few videos. So this is number one of the few videos that I will film right now while I have the house to myself and no one around. So first video, as you guys have seen from the title, is just about eating during the holidays. So as you guys know, I am a nutrition student, technically graduate. I just graduated with my degree in sports nutrition and then minoring in supplementary nutritional science. So that does mean that I am technically qualified to give some of this information. I may not be a registered nutritionist yet, but that is in the process. Got to apply for all that. But nonetheless, I am technically qualified for the information that I'm going to say. Most of it is just little tips and tricks. There's nothing too fancy, nothing too technical. But yeah, if you want a little bit of guidance around eating and exercise during the holiday period, keep on watching. Alright, so I've got about like five little tips and tricks to deal with holidays and eating. So I understand that everyone is completely different. Everyone has different goals around the holidays. Some people might be bulking, cutting, especially everyone that does their summer shreds. And some people are just maybe a little bit cautious and careful about what they eat. So everybody's situations are different. Everyone spends the holidays different. And when I say holidays, I am meaning, you know, Christmas, New Year's, that kind of period around Christmas time at the end of the year, when generally everyone goes and sees their families, goes home and does all of the fun stuff around the New Year's time and the holidays. So yeah, that's kind of what I'm referring to when I say the holidays. So pretty much my first thing is, do not restrict yourself. You are going home, you're seeing family, this is the time of the year to, you know, enjoy the little things. Eat that trifle for dessert, you know, have that extra helping of potato salad at Christmas dinner. So yeah, like, don't restrict yourself. You are there to eat, to enjoy yourself. And yeah, you may have some goals in mind, but that shouldn't be a problem in terms of enjoying yourself and spending time with your family. You're gonna regret it more if you come home over the Christmas, everyone is diving into mum's homemade chocolate chip cookies and you're sitting there going, oh, probably shouldn't eat those. Trust me, eat the damn cookie. You will enjoy it so much more and you won't regret it as much back in the long run. People often think that the food that they're going to consume over Christmas is like, boom, I'm going to eat a plate of dessert at Christmas, on Christmas Day, Christmas night, and I'm going to get fat, I'm going to lose all my gains. Just here to break it to you, that's not correct. If you just eat the way that you want to, you're going to be fine, I promise you that. If you just eat the dessert, eat the dinner, just enjoy yourself and you can focus back on your goals and go back to your regular eating schedule in a few days' time, you know, after the whole holidays have been. But for the meantime, don't restrict yourself. Eat the damn cookie. Second tip, now this is to do with exercise. So a lot of people think, oh no, I've eaten so much more food at Christmas, I'm gonna have to go exercise to burn it all off. I'm gonna have to go on a detox. I'm gonna have to do all this crazy stuff. I'm gonna have to do a million hours of cardio. Again, this is not the case. Please do not go and do this. It's not gonna be good for your body whatsoever. The calories that you consume on Christmas Day or around the holidays, it is what it is. And no amount of cardio the next day, it's just not gonna do any difference, guys. If you want to exercise, be my guest, absolutely go for it. But you don't necessarily have to go to the gym and run a million miles, and you don't have to go and do the biggest HIIT cardio workout of your life just to make up for Christmas. You should not have to make up for Christmas. You eat to fuel your body, and you know, exercise is just that thing that we do on the side to keep ourselves healthy and to keep ourselves fit and strong. You shouldn't have to exercise to make up for what you eat. That being said, some good examples of what you could do around the Christmas time. You may not necessarily be able to go to a gym, say if you're back home, just go for a walk, take your family with you, take your dogs if you have them. These are sort of things that are just nice and easy you can do with your family and a technically exercise, technically cardio. But yeah, you're just doing it with your family and it's enjoyable. Maybe get outside, play some backdoor cricket, go down to the park and play on the playground with your cousin. I know that's what I was doing the other day and whew, it was a little bit of a struggle, you know, chucking a few pull-ups in there if you want. I tried to, that's one of the goals for the new year. But anyway, you don't have to exercise to make up what you eat, and I promise you that, team. You just exercise to make yourself feel good, and you also eat to make yourself feel good. There should be no eating to make up for it. Alright, number three, eat what makes you so happy. So obviously around the Christmas time, around the holidays, if you're having a big family get together, it's very likely that you're going to have some meat, some vegetables, some carbohydrates, some pasta salad, potato salad, and you're probably going to have desserts as well. And so when I say eat to make you so happy, you just eat whatever you would like. I know that for me personally, I probably go to the green salad last. And I'm going through the line of food. For me personally, I'd probably go potatoes first, then some meat, and then maybe some like carbohydrate salad or something, like a pasta or potato salad. Then I'll probably go to that green salad with all the beans and, you know, your carrot and your generic salad like that. So yeah, I do that because that's what makes my soul happy. I know that I want my plate filled up with all of those delicious, delicious foods that I maybe don't get to eat so much when I'm back home because of all the costs, like I buy that sort of stuff. But yeah, I eat to make myself happy. And you guys definitely should too. That being said, tip number four, coming in strong, is tips for dieting over the holidays. And so, I don't necessarily think you should diet over the holidays. It's not necessary, but by all means, if that's your goal, if you have a certain physique in mind, you might be cutting, you might be bulking. There are certain ways that you can help with this around the holidays in terms of eating. In particular, when we're talking about bulking, obviously. Eat all the food. Christmas time's probably the best time to eat all the food. A lot of the time, the stuff there is very high calorie. And you know what? It's super easy to consume. I mean, I could sit there and eat a couple of bowls full of trifle, full of sponge and custard and cream and fruit. Oh. But you know what I mean? Like, that's quite a few calories in itself. Not that it matters, because I'm going to eat it nonetheless. But if you're bulking, holidays, perfect time to do that. Although on the other hand, if you are cutting and you are, you know, in your little summer shred sort of thing, I have a little tip for you when it comes to getting food. My first part of it is, just like I've been saying this whole thing, eat whatever you want. It's not going to affect your cutting, bulking, whatever. You keep going with it afterwards. So for now, that's fine. But if you did want a little tip, it's one that I've seen on Instagram quite a few times, and I just think it's absolutely brilliant. It's when you're looking at all the food that there is, say, for Christmas dinner. You know what you do? You take your plate, you go to those salads first, and you grab a decent serving of the salads, and then you make your way to the meat. Some really good protein, or if you don't eat meat, whatever the main protein source is for your family at Christmas. So you go to there, you go salad, you go meat, and then by the time you get to the meat, there's probably not going to be a lot of room left on your plate for any of the really like high carb, maybe pasta salads and all that sort of stuff. So you can still get those, obviously there's still space on your plate. You fill it up with those carbohydrates, but it just means that you're going to have slightly less than, say, if you started with that, you know, you're very likely in the whole moment of it to scoop up a big serving of it and chuck it on your plate. So yeah, start with the salads, make your way to the meats, and then go to those more carbohydrate heavy things, and then you still get to enjoy everything that you want, but you're a little bit more cautious about the portionings of different sizes on your plate. And finally, this is the biggest thing that I need to hone into you right now. Enjoy yourself. Just enjoy yourself. It's the holidays. You're around family. You get to eat all this super, super fun food. It's absolutely delicious. And I just want you to enjoy yourself. Don't miss out on all the amazing memories that you can make with your family. You know, one of my favorite times of the year is Christmas, because you get together with your family. You all sit around the Christmas table, or you sit outside because it's summer in New Zealand. And you're all sitting there with your giant plates full of food, and you're all eating and happy, and it's just some of the best memories that I've made when you're laughing around the Christmas dinner table with all of the food there. And you know what? Going back for seconds as well, because seconds is where it's at, and all the leftovers that you get to eat the next day. Oh, this is probably why Christmas is one of my favorite holidays, is because there's so much food. And your girl loves food. So yeah, I just want you guys to enjoy yourself. And even if it comes to New Year's, you might be similar to my family, where you'd also do kind of a big meal on New Year's Eve or New Year's Day to celebrate coming into the new year. It's exactly the same as Christmas. You're going to have all this food around. You've got your snacks, you've got your dips and crackers and cheese and all that fun stuff. So just enjoy yourself. Think about all the exercise and stuff later. It'll be absolutely fine. But once again, do not use exercise to compensate for what you eat. You eat to fuel your body, you exercise to be healthy. You don't use them to compensate. Do not detox or do any of those silly things. Your body detoxes itself. That's what your liver's there for. Do not restrict yourself. Eat the damn cookies, eat the trifle, eat all of the potato salad, and just enjoy yourself, guys. Eat to make yourself happy and enjoy the holiday spent with your family after the year that we've had in 2020. I think it's what everybody needs. I do understand overseas, it is a little bit harder, and my heart goes out to you guys. It might not be able to spend your holidays with your family. Hopefully you get some good FaceTiming in there and you can share that way with them. But other than that, guys, I really hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you take these tips to heart. And yeah, Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays, and I'll see you next time. Bye.